हेलो, दिस इज़ मसूद अंसारी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी, एपीएसएम कॉलेज बरौनी। एज वी नो दैट देर आर थ्री काइंड्स ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट, लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट, फील्ड एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड नेचुरल एक्सपेरिमेंट। इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट, व्हाइल इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फील्ड एक्सपेरिमेंट। देन आफ्टर वी विल ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट द नेचुरल एक्सपेरिमेंट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो। सो वाट इज द फील्ड एक्सपेरिमेंट? This is the first question. So field experiments are done in the real life environment of the participant. The experimenter still manipulates the independent variable while he is unable to control extraneous variable. If you will recall about the lab experiment, you will come to know that in lab experiment, experimenter was able to control extraneous variable as well. And he is also manipulating the independent variable. But in case of field experiment, experimenter can only manipulate to the independent variable while he is unable to control extraneous variable. This is the basic difference between lab experiment and field experiment. Now come to the strength and limitations of the field experiment. So first strength of the field experiment is a field experiment is more likely to reflect real life because of natural setting. That is why there is higher ecological validity as compared to lab experiment, because lab experiment take place under the highly controlled condition and that is conducted in the laboratory setting, while field experiment take place outside the laboratory and natural setting. So this is the first strength of the field experiment, that experiment is more likely to reflect real life because of the natural setting. What is the second strength of the field experiment? So second strength of the field experiment is there is less likelihood of demand characteristics affecting the result, as participant may not know they are being studied. So these are the two main important strength of the field experiment. First one is natural setting, that is why there is a higher ecological validity as compared to lab experiment. Second strength is there is less likelihood of demand characteristics affecting the result, as participant may not know that they are being studied. So as we know that every experiment has some strength and limitation as well. So what are the limitations of the field experiment? Major limitation of the field experiment is, in this experiment, an experimenter is unable to control extraneous variable. And because of control or making constant to the extraneous variable, there is more probability that result may be affected. Now come to the an example so that we can understand that what kind of methods and procedure experimenter adopt to conduct the field experiment. One experiment was conducted by Hofling, and that is conducted in the hospital setting outside of the laboratory in 1966. What he did and how he conducted study. Aim of the Hofling was to create a more realistic study of obedience by carrying out field studies on nurses who were unaware that they were involved in an experiment. So what was the method to conduct this study? The procedure involved a naturalistic field experiment involving 22 night working nurses. And experimenter was Dr. Smith. Called the nurses at hospital on 22 different occasions. He didn't call at a time all the 22 nurses, but he called all the nurses different occasions and asked them to check to see if they have the necessary drug. When the nurse checks, she can see that the maximum doses is supposed to be 10 mg. When they reported to the doctor, they were told to administer 20 mg, that is double of the drug, to a patient called Mr. Jones. That may not be real name in this experiment. Usually experimenter use some hypothetical name so that anonymity can be maintained. So Dr. Smith was in a desperate hurry, and he would sign the authorization form when he came to see Mr. Jones later on. The nurses were asked to see what they would do. This was the intention of the experimenter, that what they will do after they getting instruction. The medication was not real because it was conducted an experiment to understand the obedience. That is why experimenter used a placebo. The drug was not real, while nurses thought that it is real. Now, what is the independent variable in this experiment and what is the dependent variable in this experiment? Independent variable in this experiment is instruction given, or you can say order by higher authority or doctor is given, that is independent variable. While obedience or following the instruction is the dependent variable. So what factors can be extraneous variable about which experimenter is not interested to see? So there may be some extraneous variables like fear of job loss, getting scolded, fear of transfer, etc. While these extraneous variables are not studied by the experimenter, so what kind of discrepancies take place if nurses will follow these instruction? So if the nurse administered the drug, they will have broken three hospital rules. First one is, they are not allowed to accept instruction over the phone. This is the first point, and it means taking instruction over the phone for any patient might be unethical, because as per the prescription of the medicine depends upon the condition of the patient. So whoever other side of the phone is not able to see the condition of the patient, then how he can prescribe any amount of drug or any type of drug to the patient? So this is the first point, that they are not allowed to accept instruction over the phone. Second point is, the dose was double as the maximum limits stated on the box. As we know that prescription of the medicine was 10 mg, while nurses were getting instruction to administer 20 mg, that is just double of the medicine. And third point is, the medicine itself is unauthorized. Why it was unauthorized? Because it was not on the ward stock list. This is the third point. These are the three points which will be violated by the nurses if they will follow the instruction given by the doctor over the phone. Now come to the next, what happened in the result. Result shows that out of 20 nurses, 21 nurses followed the instruction given by the doctor. They were not supposed to take instruction by phone, let alone exceed the allowed dose, though the drug was a placebo. Even the drug was placebo, nurses are not supposed to accept or follow the instruction given by the doctor. And next, second point in the result was found, when other nurses were asked to discuss what they would do in the similar situation, and this is the control group, they were not getting any instruction by the doctor. So out of the 22 nurses in the control group, 21 nurses replied they will not comply with the order. they will not follow the order given on the over the phone by the any higher authority or doctor, because that was unethical. So what is the conclusion? Hoffling demonstrated that people are very unwilling to question supposed authority, even when they might have good reason to. He was interested to know that what is the influence of instruction given by higher authority on the subordinates, if they follow or not. So they found that instruction given by higher authorities or doctors to the nurses were followed in the most of the cases in the experimental group, while in control group 21 nurses replied that they will not comply the order or instruction over the phone. So this was the field experiment which was conducted outside the laboratory and in the real setting. And another difference was experimenter only can manipulate to the independent variable, while he was unable to control to the extraneous variable. And extraneous variable must have some influence on the dependent variable, or you can say behavior of the nurses. If you have any question, you can ask in the interactive session has been scheduled from Monday to Friday. You can get link of the interactive session from the college website. And in the next video, we will discuss about the natural experiment.